Hi mga listeners and followers sa Yasinian Freedom Board. Welcome back again sa tuwang YouTube channel o karon another confession na sad. Siyempre, kauban ang inyuhang bay gamay o ang title sa confession, sa love, there is forgiveness. Please call me Dayan. Graduate ko sa UC Maine. Di lang na ako isulti unsa nga kurso o what year kay naa niya'y makailan ako. My story goes like this. I was with my ex-boyfriend for 2 years when I decided to have a bit of fun kay na-bored na ko niya. I cheated on him sa among classmate rapod. Yes, classmate Ming Tulo. Last year na mo sa kurso nga nag-start ang akong kabuang. The relationship went on for 2 years and on those 2 years, akong giblayan akong uyab o ako ang classmate pod. Pero nagbuwag rapod me sa akong boyfriend o classmate for different reasons. Sa akong boyfriend, kay nasakpan mi niya ni classmate. O ni classmate, kay nag-cheat siya nako o mangulata siya. Fast forward, 2 years later, nagka-recon ni kog balik sa akong elementary crush. Nikalitra siya og chat nako sa FB. I was single that time and I'm really curious how he turned out. Let's call him Liam. Nashock jud ko pagkita namo because he changed so much. He's now tall, chiseled, og ni gwapo siya pagayo. Liam is an epitome of my dream guy. Paguna namo kita, perte namong istorya nga naabtan mi og unom ka oras nga istorya ratanan. We cramped the past 10 years sa katong night. We've talked about everything under the sun and I found out nang migrate di ay sila sa iyang pamilya sa Europe pag graduate na mo o grade 6. Pero bisan na siya sa gawas, dili jud siya arte. He's still the same down to earth guy I've known since elementary. Ako sad siya nga gisultian about sa akong love life. I've told him everything, including my cheating. Nalingaw jud ko istorya niya kay bisan iya ko gibadlong sa akong nabuhat, wala yun siya ni judge nako. We went out a couple more times og na-develop jud among feelings for each other. I know it's not going to last kay he needs to go back sa iyang country and continue living his life while mag-stay ako dari sa Cebu. Sa iyang last day, ako siyang gihatod sa airport. Umiyon si Liam nako nga I'll come back for you. Nangutana ko kung kanusa. Mitubag siya nga, next year, makahuwat ka? Mitubag ko nga, I don't know, kahibalo na biya ka sa akong cheater history. Pag mayon si Liam, Dayan, you need to choose to let go of that person. It's not who you are anymore. Learn to forgive yourself. Pag mayon ko nga, I don't think I can do this LDR thing. Pag mayon si Liam, you don't have to decide now. We'll keep in touch lang ha? Miingon ra pud ko og sure. Pero wala siya kabalo nga namakako niya. I didn't plan on keeping in touch. I've decided to let go of what we have and call it a summer fling. So every time nga mulag in siya sa FB, igkita na ko nga online siya, magdali-dali ko og offline. That went on for 3 weeks. Wala ra pud siya ni message nako. So I took it a sign nga dili sad siya interesado. Until one day, wala ko kabantay nga online na day siya. Ni-message siya nako nga nangumusta. Mingon si Liam, Dayan, finally, naabtan jud di ka. How have you been? Og akong giistorya niya ang tinuod. Mingon ko niya, nga nagsigi kog offline para di ko nimo maabtan. If I tell you I'm fine, I'd be lying. O nangata na si Liam nako, nga have you decided nga what we have is a risk not worth taking? Mitubag ko nga, no, quite the opposite really. I think it's worth losing too much that I'm afraid. I'm afraid to get hurt, to disappoint you in case I do something stupid again. And I'm afraid that this might not work and will be left with nothing. O mitubag si Liam, I've been thinking about us all the time since I got here. Huwag ako siyang giingnan nga I've missed you. And that one statement changed my life. After ko nisulti niya nga gimingaw ko niya, We've talked for a couple more hours and decided to be a couple. And it was the best decision I've made. He was the best boyfriend anyone could ask for. Grabe din siya, makapangga na ako. And he is sweet, kind, generous, and loving. We've bridged our distance through FB and Skype. Sige din mi og chat or Skype every day without miss. He proposed after 4 months sa among relationship. Ni uli jud iyang parents sa Pinas to meet mine and talk about our coming wedding. Best moment jud to sa akong life. I didn't think I deserve all these things considering what I did years ago. I savored it nonetheless. We got married in a simple garden wedding. Ang iyahang pamilya ang gagasto sa tanan kay wala jud kaayo makontribute akong family kay pobre mangud mi. A few months after the wedding, nadala na ko niya sa Europe. It was too hard at first kay wala ko'y kaila and walay work. Nara ko permis sa balay while he works. I can't complain on my new husband though. Liam is every bit as loving as when we were boyfriend-girlfriend, if not more. Eventually, naka-work ko diri and I was happy that I could finally contribute financially. Liam and I decided nga mag-baby na me after a year because stable naman sad me. Liam has a good position in a big company. Nitry ko apply sa same company nga iyahang giworkan and nadawat pud ko. Dili mi same department but makita rami. Everything went well for a couple of months. Liam is still the loving husband I could only wish for. Until one day, nakabantay ko nga si Liam tagdugay na muli. Sige siyag ingon nga overtime daw. Naamangod sila'y dako nga project. Nag-goal ko kay naanadjud ko nga permi mi kuyog. But I know, para rani sa mong future. Kani si Liam, may pagka-workaholic sa jud ni siya, so wala ra ko na concern. It continued being like that for 3 months. Until one day, na ako'y nadunggan nga istorya within the office nga si Liam daw ug ang iyahang kauban sa department nga si Carly has a secret relationship. Someone saw them leaving Carly's apartment nga duol ra pod sa balay sa among usa ka kauban. I can't believe what I've heard, kahilakon ko pero akong gipungan. I don't want to believe in rumors and would want to hear the truth from my husband. Apparently, it has been going on for several months but no one had evidence until the recent sighting. Niuli ko ito nga day nga guol kayo. I waited for Liam to go home pero as usual, late na po daw siya mauli. Ako siyang ipangutana, nga what time are you going to be home today, babe? Untubag siya nga, I need to finish a couple of things kay weekend biya ugma. This can't wait. Mga midnight na ko muuli, babe. Don't wait up. Ugmingon na lang po ko, nga okay, I'll see you tomorrow then. I sleep that night with eyes drenched in tears. Bisan wala pa na-confirm ni Liam akong suspicion, I know in my heart nga he's got someone else. I am determined to know the truth the next day. I drifted in a restless sleep. The next day, after me nag-breakfast, ako siyang giingnan. Liam, I need to ask you something and I want to know the truth. Pamitubag si Liam, nga I'm afraid this day would come. I know what you're going to ask. Yes, it's true. I'm with Carly. We've been going out for 6 months na behind your back. I know daghan og istorya about namo sa opisina. I would like to be the one to tell you but obviously, someone beat me to it. Well, gatulo na akong luha ng utana ko niya. Why? Dahil kuwang na ko. Umingon siya nga, I'm so sorry, Dayan. I was weak. She is attractive. And I am attracted. The whole time nga nag-istorya mi, emotionless kayo si Liam. Feeling na ako, this is karma hitting me hard on the face. Fate has served it to me cold. At this time, I thought I had my fairy tale. Huwag ako siyang gignan. I just want to know kung love pa ko ni mo. And if you want to start over and end it with Carly. Ang gitubag ni Liam, I want a divorce. Mora kog nabungog sa akong nadunggan. I felt like the whole world is crashing down on me. So akong gibuhat, mitando ko og nilakaw sa among room para mohilak. I've looked at everything sa room while reminiscing everything we've gone through as a couple. Sayang kay siya, but I know when I'm not needed anymore. After a while, Liam went in our room. Mingon siya nga, I'm sorry babe. I know how hard this is for you, but I want to be with her. Huwag ako siyang gipangutan na, can you please tell me what I could have done differently para wala kamatintal? Wala nakatingog gadget si Liam, o pagkatotood, mingon siya nga, we need to decide a few details sa to separation. Don't worry about the lawyer's fee. I got it. I'll give you your half sa atong properties plus you can have all of our savings. I owe you that much. Mitubag ko nga, I don't need all that. Ikaw akong kinahanglan and I'm willing to do everything to fix our marriage. Umingon si Liam, nga babe please, don't make this any harder. Ganahan ko og divorce. I don't love you anymore. It's Carly whom I love. Sakto juday sila. Lisod pugson ang tao nga dili na. It felt like my soul was split in two. I've recalled all the good times that we had and it made my heart ache more. Gan is the sweet and carefree guy I've married. Whenever I look at Liam, he's not the same guy anymore. He is harsh and cold. Nihangyo ko ni Liam to let me stay a couple more days while I sort out my new living arrangement. I moved to the spare bedroom while packing my things. Carly moved in and a couple of days later. My side of the bed has not even gone cold yet. Iyahan ang gipapuyo iyahang kerida. She's now the queen of his household and I can't do anything because his love is no longer mine. After a week nga gikan sa mong istorya, nibalhin ako sa kuang new place. The divorce proceedings would take months to be finalized kadaghan pa og stages. While it's still ongoing, I've resigned from my job nga kauban ming tulo og kumpanya and decided to move farther away from the area. While packing up my things, nidol si Carly og Liam nako. Mingan si Carly nga, thanks for not taking us to HR. I know they would have fired both of us if you went and complained. Og mitubag ko nga, I have no desire to take something you've worked so hard for. I hope you've felt the same before you seduced my husband. Amingon si Liam, come on Dayan. Carly went here to thank you. You don't need to insult her. Huwag ako siyang giinan. It's funny, isn't it? You have the nerve to ask me to be grateful because she thanked me for not getting both of you sacked. Umingon si Liam nako. Nga look, when this is all over, I hope we can all be at least civil to each other. Our lawyer would be in touch to let you sign the papers once it's finalized. Og mitubag na lang ko nga sure. For now, goodbye Liam and Carly. I do wish you find happiness with each other. A few days after ko ni-resign, nakakitara dayon ko og work sa usa ka startup company. It helped me a lot to keep my mind off things. Until one day, nimata ko nga gasuka-suka. Niadto ko og ospital to confirm my suspicion. 14 weeks pregnant na day ko, nya wala ko kabantay tungod sa akong kabisi o kagol. Nihilak jud ko paingon sa doktor. I didn't want my kid to grow up without a dad, but wala ko'y choice. Bisan lisod, I took care of myself better because I have a child growing in me. Nagduduha ko usultian ba na ako si Liam nga pregnant ko. I decided against it a couple of times within the past month. Pero after a while, nakunho na ako nga he has the right to know. He may not have been a good husband to me, but maybe he can be a good father to our child. So I decided to call. Ngayon ko nga, hi Liam, sorry nakadisturbo ko nimo. Nalang unta ako'y toyo nimo. Umingon si Liam, nga look Dayan, now is not a good time for me. Wala ko siyang gingnan. Nga, I won't take a lot of your time. I just need to tell you something important. Og nasuko na si Liam. Ngayon siya nga, di ka kasabot? I'm in a rush karon. I'm not in the mood to talk about your feelings or anything to do with you. Og miingon na lang ko nga okay. No worries. I'm sorry to have bothered you. Wala pa ganay ko kahuman og storya ayahan ng gi-end ang call. To be honest, I didn't recognize the person I was speaking to. Nausab jug pag-ayo si Liam, I finally decided to take it as a sign to keep the pregnancy to myself. Around 6 months preggy ko, gi-assign ko sa akong boss sa Laenya City. So I've decided to move again. I've texted Liam my PO box address pero natoy forwarding in case need na ko mo-sign sa mong divorce papers. Di ko ganahan nga makatol-tol siya kung asa na ko nagpuyo. So I've changed my number and went with my maiden name bisan wala pa may ma-divorce. Life went on for me until nanganak ko. My baby girl is a spitting image of me but with her father's jet black eyes and hair. I've named my daughter Leanne and she's the most wonderful kid a parent could ask for. Liwat kaya siya siyang daddy og batasan nga hilomon and well-behaved. Akong ipaapas kadali akong sister sa Euro para na ako'y mauban while recovering gikan panganak. Sige siya og pangutana na ako unsa ang nahitabo. I told her everything but made her promise not to tell anyone, even my parents. Di ko ganahan mag-uol sila na ako. Ang ilang nahibalan, wala na may nagkasinabot maong nag-divorce. It's not too far-fetched anyway because we got married too quickly. I've cut ties with Liam's family pod kaya ganahan jud ko nga mag-start to fresh. Akong gi-deactivate akong FB and Liam is not posting things on his FB with Carly on it kay wala pa sad biya na human among divorce. Nahadlok ko ro siya nga makiha. He didn't know I have no plans in pursuing anything. 6 months gigan ko ng anak, niuli na kong sister balik sa Cebu. Well, nibalik na ko work. Dimanggod ko ka-leave og dugay kaya was given by my boss an opportunity to spearhead a project. Leanne would be in a daycare all day till makuha na nako siya igahapon after work. This went on for a while kaya wala jud makatabang og babysit nako. Looking back, liso jud siya but nakaya ra nako. All night I will cuddle her to sleep but before that I would always show her photos of her daddy on my phone. Photos of him and us together when we were still happy. Bisan pa sa gibuhat ni Liam nako, I still love him and I want our child to know and love him as well. Nakahilak jud ko kaya ang first word sa mong anak is dada while looking at her dad's photo. It broke my heart thinking what we could have been. Pero I have to remain strong for Leanne. Fast forward 3 years. Nagdali-dali ko uguyod ni Leanne while galakaw sa city kay hapit na may malate sa Lion King play nga among tanawan. Ganahan po siyang mulakaw og di siya pakugos so nagbalaw ko og bitad. Ngayon si Leanne, nga mami, want to toilet. Og mingon ko nga, okay baby, let's go to toilet. Og mingon si Leanne, nga just wait outside ma'am, I can go by myself. Bisan niya nagkadayungit iyang agi, di yun siya pakuyog. Kaniya kong anak, nagdako jud ni siya nga may pagka-independent. Anan magud siya nga permi ko nga nasa work, well nagulat ko sa gawas, na ay mitawag na ko. Dayan, og nang luspad ko kachot. Og mingon ko nga, uy, kumusta? Long time no see. Sige ko gotuwat sa papers, wala manabot. Nag-return address ay mo? Og miingon si Liam, nga wow, you're too keen to sign that paper eh. Mitubag ko niya, nga I was just wondering because it's been 3 years, Liam and I haven't received anything. Og miingon si Liam, nga where have you been Dayan? I've looked everywhere for you. Ask your family, my family, your friends, but no one can tell me where you are. Mitubag ko nga, diri ras kilid-kilid oy, og may katawa. Og may abot si Leanne. Og may ingon, Mami, I'm finished. Nilingi ko sa kong anak, kanaan na diay sa kong kilid nga wala o kabantay. Nitanaw si Liam niya, pero ambot lang og nakamayong ba siya sa iyang anak. Og sa dihang, miingon si Lian, "Daddy, pogos." Wala jud ko katingog sa gisulti sa kong anak. Wala ko nag-expect nga makaila siya sa iyang papa nga mga karaan man to nga picture sa kong gipakita niya, katong kuha pa nako sa kong phone. Wala mitingog si Liam pero ihang giaswat si Lian. Umingon si Liam, "How are you, baby girl? Did you miss daddy?" Umitubag si Lian, nga, "Yes, I miss you, daddy. Mommy said you live far, far away." Nagtinanaway ming duha ni Liam og halos di ko kaharong og tanaw niya. Pero nakita nako siyang mata ang grabe nga pagmahay og guilt while nagkugos siya sa among anak. Umingon ko nga, "Baby, let's go na, late na ta sa play." Umingon si Lian, "But I want to stay with my daddy." Og ako siyang giingnan, "Nga busy man si daddy, anak. Come to mom and be a good girl, okay? Daddy still needs to go somewhere." Akong gikuha si Lian niya, og halos mudaga na lang ko. Umingon si Lian, "Bye daddy, we love you." Nagbaw jud ko og pugong sa kong luha. Mamugod na ang among idungan og salty every night before me matulog after me mutanaw sa mga pictures. So nitalikod ko dayon og nagpaspas og lakaw paingon sa entrance sa play. Oy, mikalit og ingon si Liam, "Nga dayan, wait, pwede ta mag-istorya? Please?" Huwag ako siyang itubag, "Nga sorry kay Liam, late na mi sa play. Please have your lawyer send the papers so I could sign it. Same P.O. box address, okay?" Umiingon si Liam, "Nga dayan, we have a lot to talk about. Please." Nisulod ko diritso sa venue sa play while gakugos ni Lian. Wajud ko umlingi. Makita ko niya si Liam sa kong mata nga love pagyapon ako siya huwag ang mga luha nga nitulo. May ganing ngit-ngit na ang venue kay nagsugod naman. Walay nakabantay na ako nga nakila ko. Si Lian pod kay concentrate kaayo siya sa play. Pag uman sa play, nagdali-dali may ugawas kauban sa majority sa crowd pang camouflage just in case Liam is still waiting outside. Padulong na ko labang sa dihang naay ni Huno nga sakyanan sa mga tubangan. Umingon si Lian, "Daddy!" Umingon si Liam nako, "Nga get in dayan, need ta magistorya." Nisulod ko sa auto nga wala ako sa buton sa ang dapat na akong bation. Nahadlo ko nga ilugo ni Liam ang akong anak or makigtunga siya og custody sa bata. Nihunong among gisakyan sa tubangan sa restaurant. Umingon si Liam, "I reckon this is the best place to talk. I'm sure gigutom na pod mo." Umingon si Lian, "Nga I'm gutom, daddy." Umingon si Liam, "Nga yes, baby girl. It's daddy's treat tonight. What would my princess like?" Naminaw ra ko nilang duha nga gistorya. They sound like they've known each other for one lifetime, not a few hours. So ako ra silang gisagdahan sa ilang interaction because I don't know what else to do. My daughter is so happy to see her dad and I can't take it away from her. Umingon si Liam, "Nga dayan, I would like to apologize for a lot of things I put you through." Tubag ko nga, "It's in the past, we've all moved on." Ang langutan na si Liam, "Nga have you?" "Not me. I've spent the last 2 years looking for you. I initially thought you went home to Philippines." Umitawag ko niya, "Na, life has been good to me after the whole breakup." Mas nindot ang opportunity ni Lian og nako diri. Umingon si Liam, "Nga babe, sorry jud kaayo sa akong nabuhat. If I could turn back time, I would have made a better choice. You have always been the better part of me. I was just too blinded with what I thought was the finer things in life. I didn't know what I had till I went home one day and the warmth you've created to our home is gone. When I can no longer hear your high-pitched laugh every time I crack a joke. When the smell of the person beside me in bed is not the same sweet scent that reminded me of tulips and calla lilies. When all I ever looked forward to after a long day's work is your hug, kisses, an endless chatter of how your day went, when all I ever look forward to after a long day's work is your hug, kisses, an endless chatter of how your day went. Please take me back. Umingon ko nga, Liam, please. It hurts so much I can't go back. It was really hard. I may not make it if I have to redo the whole thing. Umingon si Liam, nga dayan, please think about it. I know it's too early to decide, but I want to be part of your life again. I want my daughter to go home to a family. Let me make this right, I beg you. After ito nga dinner, ni-insist ko nga di lang miniya ihaton. I didn't want him to know where we live. He insisted on getting my number so akong gihatag niya kay di jud miniya papulion till makuha niya akong number. That night, I've evaluated how I felt making Liam a part of my daughter's life. Nagunaw na sad ko kung napasaylo na ba nako siya and if I'm willing to take him back. Gusto ko makasure unsa iyahang tinuod nga reason to get back together. I wouldn't want to start again kung naluoy lang siya nako or tungod lang sa among anak. I want to ascertain these feelings for me. So 2 days after sa among dinner, nagsabot mi nga magkita og balik para magistorya. Nagibutang si Liam nga envelope sa table. Akong giablihan to find our divorce papers. Unsigned. Unita na ako niya. O nangutana ko nga, bag-o ni nga draft sa papers, nagpuno ka para custody pod. O mingon si Liam, look closely dayan. It's the same paper you've signed 3 years ago pag initial na to apply for divorce. I can't bring myself to sign it, bisan ako ang nangayog divorce. Carly was so pleased nga nung galangay-langay ko. I've told her we'll have to wait for a year before we can file it. I lied. I didn't know what I wanted that time, pero I can't bear to pick up a pen and sign the damn paper. Unangutan ako niya, what's the point of telling me this? Umingon si Liam, I just want you to know how sorry I am for everything you've gone through because I was too stupid and weak to see what is in front of me. I went around wishing for things I thought nga makapalipay na ako. I pursued Carly because she is beautiful, ambitious, and every man's dream. I thought I needed a woman who is my equal. Too hard, too simple, too docile, too good, and too contented with life's trivialities that I've mistaken it for lack of ambition. Pagmingon ko niya, nga dugay na kayo to Liam hoy. Let's not rehash the past palihog lang. If you want custody sa mong anak, it would be a hard bargain. I live in the city now ug di ko pwedeng mobalhin kay diri na among life ni Lian. Umingon si Liam, I'm only asking for a chance to be part of your life again. I still love you, Dayan. I loved you then. I love you now. I've never stopped loving you even if I've said those hurtful words to you. Huwag ako siyang gipangutana while gahila ko. Then why? Kahibalo ba ka? Unsa kasakit ang madunggan tugi ka nimo? Umingon si Liam nako. Nga, I'm so sorry, babe. I've made a mistake. Let me make it up to you. I want us to be a family again. After ato nga meeting namo, nisugot ko nga si Liam o bisita namo sa balay para makabanding siya sa mga anak. Nagsugod na po dogaan akong buot niya. He is so good to our daughter, and he makes her happy. Nalipay pod ko nga nakaila na akong anak si Ham Papa. We've decided to get to know each other again. A lot of things have changed in the last 3 years. Dito na ko nahibalaan that Liam broke it off with Carly 2 months after I've moved out. Modeng wala yun siya ni post og photos nilang duha sa FB. Kay abi ra na ko og nahadlok lang siya nga makiha kay nangabit. They have been arguing because Liam wouldn't sign the papers and she got fed up and left. Pagmingon si Liam, the house, it's still there. It's still the same as how you left it. I didn't let Carly change anything and na-read the house of your touch. Wala ko siyang gingnan. Nga mo siguro nga sige mo gaway. Abi niya nga emotionally attached pa kanako. Pagmingon si Liam, nga it's our home. I feel sick to my stomach having desecrated it by letting Carly live there even before we're officially divorced. Wala ko siyang gipangutana nga why did you decide to keep it that way? Remember, you kicked me out of the house and in your life because you don't want me in it. Tumingon si Liam nga wala jud ko kabalo dayan. I was so torn between what I thought I want and what my heart is telling me. It's like a brain versus heart thing and I was so confused. Bisan nung nag-try me og work on sa mong relationship, I didn't let him stay in my place. I believe it was safer that way. He has a place in the same city namo, kaya naa siya project for 6 months dito nga gi-manage. That's why nagkakita mi. Every day mo bisita siya and he always bring me flowers. Mura siya nanguyab og balik nako. He was not kidding when he asked if we could start over again. Mura mi og mga teenagers nga mag-uyab-uyab though guarded gihapon kayo ko. I didn't want to get hurt again. And one day, while naglingkod mi sa kitchen after na mo gipakatulog si Lian, iyang gikuha kong kamot o gisot akong engagement ring o wedding ring nga akong gibilin niya paghawaan ako. Nitanaw ko sa mata ni Liam, and I've recognized the same guy I fell in love with 5 years ago. Nitando ko og ako siyang gigakos o hugot kayo. Mato ang pinakauna nga nigakos ko niya since nagbuwag mi. He's still so familiar even after all the years. My heart remembered all the pain and tears, but it also remembered all the joy, laughs, hugs, and kisses we've shared and it knows it's finally home. Back to my one and true love. To the only man who can make and break me. I've given him my heart again knowing he can break it. The only difference is I know this time he won't. Our love is more steadfast and enduring the second time around. And fast forward 5 years, nang migrate na pod mi somewhere sa Europe. Nana may second baby ni Liam, and it's a boy. He's now 3 years old and looks so much like his father. Tall, tan, and black eyes and hair. Wala jud niliwat sa kuha bisan usa. Since we got back together, Liam has changed to be a better man. If sa una feeling nako pinangga kay ko niya, samot na karon. He's making up for all the lost times we've had. Og bisan pa usahay nga guilt still creeps up on him every time makadundum siya sa iyang nabuhat, I always reassure him that although pain and anger is a potent memory, forgiveness is a stronger antidote. And I have completely forgiven him of his shortcomings. He has made his choice and live with it. But every day is a chance to heal and make better choices in life. I've chosen to stand by him and let go of the past and make a better future for our family. Thank you all for listening my story. It's a bittersweet tale of love, but it is still beautiful all the same. Og PS, sa akong mga friends, ayaw ko itag. Please. Dayan.